So prana pratishtha is very much essential, and prana pratishtha is also a paradigmal phenomenon. Understanding all of the non-living beings as having a living consciousness inside, which can be induced only by mantras, which cannot be brought by anything else. Ananya sadhya, that cannot be contributed by anything else. That's why it has made its vyapti in the temples. In the form of mula, utsava, bhogabhera, balibhera, yagabhera, shayanabhera, gopura, vimana, dvajastambha, balipita, avarna, sthalavriksha and pushkarani. They are known as trayodashangas of temples. That the energy is permeated into various other forms which must have been told in the temple lecture that we can decide later. So this prana pratishtha, it is also somebody told Vedas are nanotechnology or not. Then I told the nanotechnology as specification. After nanotechnology, after 10 years, there may be a picotechnology, after technology, some technology may come. Nanotechnology is specified. There is a centi, milli, micro, 10 to the power of minus 14 means it is specified. And whatever we call a subtlety, that is ano or ani yan, I gave an explanation, which is told in the Shastras. You take one anu, and you take this universe. You make a proportional ratio. The ratio that exists between this single atom and this whole macrocosmic entity, the same you put in the negative integer on that side, making this, for example, if it is 1:1000, you make the 1000 part of this to be put in the other side of negative integer, and that will be the status of the subtlety of God. Even that is not capable of explaining the real status of the subtlety of God. So the proportion of the macroscopic expansion of the universe in comparison with the subtlest atom, even a subatomic particle, in the negative integer side, the same proportion is put as a comparative substratum for the other side, that will be the subtlety of God. So, the nanotechnology, it has some sense of understanding of utility of the basic particles in medicine and other applications. The same thing, for example, if somebody is giving teertham, the temple teertham is given. That is more than nanotechnology. In the subtler than the subtlest part of the teertham, the energy that is inhibited by the Agya, Padya, Achamaniya and various other sacerdotal rites that have been performed in the temple, that is mixed in the Sarvartha Doya, which is then distributed for the people for that benefit. So nanotechnology is specific. And this thing is not like that. These things are very infinitesimal. That is a certainty status of God. Next we have to come to the ashrama siddhis of our people. That is marana, force of destruction. There are innumerable types of maranas. Petrification. Ash reduction is there. Petrification is there. Ash reduction is there. Disintegration is there. Conversion is there. Immobilization is there. Innumerable siddhis are there in marana. That too, bhuta marana, desha marana, raja marana, stri marana, mrigha marana, pakshi marana, paishaja marana. Innumerable maranas are there. Then there is mohana. Mohana is alluration. Captivation is known as vashya. Fixation is known as tambhana. Intrusion is known as vedana. Procuration is known as akrushna, to create something, or to replace something, or to convert or demorphose or metamorphose something, or to bring something from a greater distance, to place in exchange about the articles available here and needed. All of these things are in akrushna. Uchchatana is instigation, and vitveshana is insight. So all of these things are there in our shastras also. And miniaturization is known as mahima. Macroscopism is known as mahima. Mass reduction is known as laghima. Mass induction is known as garima. Prapti is known as siddhi, accomplishment. Then prakamya is known as uninterrupted desire and execution. Ishitva is known as control. Pashitva is known as alluration of all entities, subservience of entities. So all of these skills are there. But those things, see, whenever we have to read something, whether it is a time pass or recreation or creation, that must be the nature of the confidence that we have to understand. We are talking about history. We learn something from history and apply for contemporary studies or futuristics. We see about dinosaurs and other things. Those things are just records that those things existed. Or all of these paranormal phenomena are just records of the past, which may not be practically implemented now. What is the use of us knowing? Can we practice something? Are somebody practicing all of these things? Can we be initiated and practice something? What is the role of energy in modern universe? What is the role of these things in the modern universe? It's challenges, hopes and demands. All of these questions are necessary to be put at the time of dealing about a concept, then at the time of conclusion. apart from all of these various things, I put it in the conclusion, there are some other things also, astrology, Vastu, see we are seeing lot of planets. Somebody asked from the National Observatory, if you want to get a nakshatra, a constellation, to send its ray or radiation to reach a person on Earth, it will take several light years. When these constellations, 27 galaxies are going to affect you, and what is the purpose of zodiac? So he is a very great criticizer in astrology, predictive astrology. Predictive astrology, it is not on spatial astrology, astronomy, astrophysics or something else. He believes in terrestrial and celestial engineering. But he is against the predictive or influential study of these things. Then what we want to say, there are two vyavaharas. One is manasika, second is prakritika. For example, if you want to go to London, it will take so many hours in flight. If you go by walk, I don't know how many months it will take. Then if you think from your reminiscences or from a picture or from somebody's recollection of experiences, you can immediately travel. So, Taijasika and Prakritika are the two modes of travel. If there is a Prakritika travel of these constellations or these planets, it may take some light years, but it is the Taijasa by the Tejas. The planets, they do have some Tejas, and the Tejas, they have a different speed rate, which is not very much equivalent or equiarduous with that of this light year travel, which is mentioned in astronomy. Well, there are different other things which are nothing but compromise and compensations if they are not without scientific base and explanations. And the Vastu is there, it is also one science. Witchcraft is there, black magic is there. Other people, they used to ask a lot of questions. What about materialization? I want to tell just few things about materialization. Apurvata, Anupalabdhi, Vilakshana, there are some qualities for materialization. If somebody materializes something, for example, somebody is giving you kumkuma, that is not anumalabdhi. He can purchase this anywhere else, but to create some belief or to make a person to be brought to his own root, he may be doing that. Anupalabdhi means that must not be available anywhere. Apurvata, which is available, but this thing is distinguishable. For example, it takes daily a color and fragrance, that kumkum. Then that is apurvata. Then vilakshana means it is keeping on showering, or it is keeping on giving some sort of benefit which is different from other things. So different from other things, distinguishable from other things, not totally available. Like that, there are lot of other things. And also in Uttama, Madhyama and Adhama, Vanchita, Kishta, Chintita is to say. If somebody materializes something as per his desire, that there is no Ishta, that is Adhama. If I am able to give anything you ask, that is known as Madhyama. You need not ask, if you think I am ready to give immediately, that is known as Uttama Siddhi. And moreover than that, then that is Hastagrahya, Hastagrahya, Parahastagrahya, Swagastam Drutha. These things are the various types of siddhis told in Shastras. If I create something within me, within my hand or within my position, that is Adhama. If I can create something in you, that is known as Uttama. If something is Hastagrahya, that which is very easily handleable within your captivation, that is inferior. If something is far beyond, if somebody is giving a pumpkin, they need pumpkin. That is a very great siddhi. So Hasta Agrahya. So a lot of other siddhis are there. They must be necessarily studied for various reasons which I am going to. Now let us come to the final point. In oral skills, intellectual skills and physical skills are powers, paranormal. What are the physical paranormal see? Number one is fortification. Nainam chindanti shastrani. Nainam dhati bhavataha, nachainam kledayantyapaha, asoshayati maharata. These things are there in Gita. It is only for soul, not for body. If a person has fortification, he finds seasonal, climatic and natural forces and their impact. From thunder, from lightning, from water, from fire, from poison, mantra, yantra, tantra, visha, abhichara, sunni, astra, sastra. All of these things are totally supportive to the person. Person will just consume everything as bone meat or boost. That is known as fortification. And second thing is trance. A person who is in samadhi, even though it is not a physical phenomenon, that gives us physical stability. A person in trance, divine trance, it may be mobile trance or immobile trance. One Sadashiva Brahmendra, you are just walking. One rogue was there waiting on the way, and he just ridiculed the person and carelessly he was just moving. And immediately, this fellow with a very big knife, He went there and he could once more, and he did not respond immediately.